Good evening, everybody from Disneyland, where it is snow. Well, it's not snowy, but it feels like it should be, and maybe it will later. I don't know.
It's only 80 degrees. Where's the snow?
80 degrees. But it's the music. It's the music, and it's the Christmas lights and all of this stuff. We are in the hub. We're making our way over to Tomorrowland because we are here for Disney Merriest Nites and mainly the Muppets.
Mainly
the Muppets. But we are going to go get into what we understand is a very long line.
Yeah.
And we will document this magical, merry evening tonight with you. And we hope you enjoy this. So let's go have a holiday party. So we heard the line inside was about 40, 45 minutes if you were already in the park. So we did leave the park, came out here. The line across the Esplanade goes all the way across to Disney California Adventure and then doubles back, which is way over there. And thankfully a good Samaritan said, hey, the line over on the side is much shorter. And so it's probably about a third of the length off to the right. So if it looks insane and you come to another Merriest Nites, this might be the quicker way in. And this line seems to be moving quicker as well. But as you can, I don't know if you can see it how well, but it's all the way across to the entrance and people are trying to get into the entrance, which is also open. So it's very confusing in the middle of the Esplanade. I would just stay over to the right and hopefully we'll be in soon. So it only took us about, what, 45 minutes or an hour?
I would say that, yeah.
About an hour to get in. They're definitely figuring out some of the kinks tonight and...
That's okay.
Yeah. Yeah, and they're putting a brave face on it, I think is a good way to put it.
Yes, they are.
But we are through, we have our maps, we have our Christmas lights and our tickets and all that stuff, so we're officially in Disney Merriest Nites now, which is great, and it's going to be a fun night because we're going to see the Muppets, and really, that's what this is all about, right?
It's honestly the whole reason for what it's about.
Basically, yeah. I mean, it'll be fun to see the parade. It'll be fun to see some of the other characters that are going to be around as well.
Yeah.
They announced Mickey and Minnie's new outfits today, and that'll be fun. And it's fun to just be here this time of year. It will be interesting to see how many people are at this event.
Yeah.
Compared to like a Disneyland After Dark.
Yeah, it's already seeming like it's a little bit more cramped and packed than a...
Which is interesting.
After Dark event, but...
Yes, so we will see how this plays out. Now, though, is the most important thing before a party like this, and that is getting food. So we are going to get some food and then hopefully get to enjoy the evening.
It floated on air. The hour was here. The time was at hand to bring in the season in more than one land. Is everyone ready? Come on. Come on in. It's time for your party to finally begin. Nights. In just 10 minutes, you're invited to join us on Main Street at
8.
Miss Piggy?
Yes, it is warm. And you are?
I'm Bill.
Oh, thank you for warming up my mic, William.
It's Bill. I'm the voice of Disneyland.
And I am Miss Piggy. Well, let me just scooch right in here. Yeah. Thank you. In just 10 minutes, the Muppets Christmas Caroling Coach will be bringing you all live
It's Bill.
Excellent behavior here.
I've been taking notes for Santa, and he will be quite pleased.
We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Are you ready to sing some Christmas carols with us?
Okay, come on, everybody.
Okay, everybody, okay, all right. You know what? We're going to start off with an easy one.
I shall go prepare the musical merriment.
Just follow along and sing Fa La La. Ready, Gonzo?
Well, I'm ready, but I'm afraid there aren't going to be any Fa La La's.
Wait, what? No Fa La La's?
He forgot to bring the Fa La La's? Unbelievable.
You'll see. Ready, Camilla?
Wow.
Deck the halls with boughs of holly.
Come on, everybody. Let's deck the halls with box of holly.
It is the season to be jolly.
Yuletide carol.
Troll? I didn't know this song had trolls. That's so cool.
Hey, goodness me. Those internet trolls can be so mean, okay?
Keep singing, Gonzo.
Yeah. See the blazing Yule before us.
Strike the harp and join the chorus.
Follow me in merry measures.
Carmen, who is this Merry Measures? When can I meet her?
No, it's not a her, Pepe. It's Merry, like happy.
Si, I'd be happy to meet her, all right.
Fast away the old year passes.
Waka 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 waka.
Follow the boy in merry
measures. Waka 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 waka. He was of the wind and weather.
All right, girls, let's take it on home. It's time to head to our next stop.
Chicken sick.
To
our next stop. Oh, whoa.
And off we go.
See you later.
Oh, boy. Excuse me. Why aren't we moving?
Maybe we are moving, but everyone is moving with us, so it just looks like we're standing still.
Tech booth, come in. Anybody there in the tech booth?
Dr. Bugs and Honeydew here in the tech booth with Larry and the Disneyland technician. Oh, yes, and Beaker. We may have a way to fix your problem.
Brent!
Yes. Tech tell me that all we have to do is find someone to crawl inside the generator and manually recharge the high voltage power supply.
That sounds dangerous.
Me? Oh, a little danger never hurt anyone. Isn't that right, Beaky? Go ahead, Beaker. That's the spirit.
Hey, Kermit, if they can't fix it, why don't we just get out and waka waka?
Good news. Beaker is now inside the generator and will try to jumpstart the high voltage power supply.
Me!
He is crawling in. He has reached the electrical panel. He is flipping the switch. Oops. Thank you again for using tech services. Please call again.
Well, I'm sure they're going to be okay. I hope. Meanwhile, does anybody have any other ideas to get us moving?
Si, Christmas magic.
Ah, great idea, Pepe.
Carmen, this was supposed to be sarcastic, Pepe.
Well, as long as we're stuck here, why don't we sing another song, huh?
Si, that's a very good idea, Carmen. Okay.
So, gang, what should we sing next for these fine people here?
Oh, how about All You Want for Christmas is Moi?
Isn't it all I want for Christmas is you?
Not the way I sing it.
That's a really nice idea, Piggy. And any other songs?
Other songs?
How about the 12 jokes of Christmas?
Rudolph the Red-Nosed Reindeer. Listen to me, all
right?
Okay, Pepe, do you know a good Christmas song?
What is this time of year again?
Christmas.
Si, de Navidad. Good. And would you say it is a happy time?
I would.
So, if it is the Feliz and the Navidad...
Oh, I get it. That's a great song.
I will sing. Jingle bells, jingle bells.
Hey, wait, Pepe. I thought you were going to sing Feliz Navidad.
Oh, why didn't I think of this already? I don't know if I can remember how it goes. Okay, this is a special song for all of you out there. For you and you and you and you and you. Let's sing. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas. I wanna wish you a Merry Christmas from the bottom. Sing along with me. Come on. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Feliz Navidad. Prospero año y felicidad. What are we gonna wish?
Happy birthday.
This is incorrect, okay? Feliz Navidad.
Amazing.
See, it's a gift.
And you were all amazing too. Come on, gang. Let's hear it for these great singers here at Disneyland.
Yay!
Unbelievable.
You can sing with one anytime.
Gee, thanks for singing with us, everybody. We'll be back. Have a great holiday.
Merry Christmas.
Hey, come back later and I'll have some new jokes. Some old jokes, but I'll have jokes.
I salute you, my fellow Disneylandians.
You travel music.
Excuse me, Mr. Kermit. Dr. Bunsen Honeydew here. I believe we have found the problem with the bus.
It isn't moving again.
Oh. Apparently, you found the problem, too.
Oh, Fozzie, stall for time. I've got an idea on how to save the show.
Yes, sir. No problem. Hey, folks, did you hear about the vampire that went out in the snow?
See, he had the frostbites.
You know that joke?
Everyone knows this joke, okay?
Oh, okay. Here's a good one. What happens to Santa if you get stuck in the chimney?
What happens is I don't get my presents.
No, he gets claustrophobic.
Oh, it's very good, okay? Very good.
You like my joke?
No, I'm just glad I'll be getting my presents.
Hey, gang. Yeah, look, even if the bus won't move, there is still a way to save the show.
Oh, you mean we're taking over Sleeping Beauty's castle?
Maybe next year, Piggy. Everybody think. Why are we here?
I'm here for my fabulous fans.
For the laughs.
For the snow.
For America.
Contractual obligations.
No. We are here to sing. So what we need to do is go out with a big finale.
I love finale.
I suggested that in a memo, didn't I?
Uh-huh. Hey, Tech Booth, cue the big finale.
Right away, Mr. Kermit.
Outside is frightful, but the fire is so delightful. And since we've no place to go,
everybody,
let it snow.
There's no signs of stopping, and I brought some corn for Bobby. But a drink way down low.
Let it snow.
Nap time. So we did just watch the Muppets. It was awesome. We'll talk more about that later. But as I'm walking down Main Street to go see what's happening in Town Square, it is fun to see that they are using projection to make it snow constantly on the walls of Main Street, the facades, I guess. And it is feeling much less busy now than it did a couple hours ago. And this is a lot of fun.
Memories of Christmas are here for me and you. Thank you. Magicians are back and better than ever.
Feliz Natal, Bon Natale, Joy Noel. In any language, we wish you a Merry Christmas. We wish you a Merry Christmas.
Christmassy, I feel like. And so I think we'll just keep walking with this, and if Katie catches up with me, we'll talk a little bit about stuff. And that was a lot of fun. I think this will probably be, it'll be interesting to see as the nights go on with a Christmas Fantasy Parade, if it continues to be the demand that it is tonight, because it was the first parade tonight, so I'm curious to see how much of a demand it is moving forward once people have already been able to see it in the parks, unless this is what people are doing for their Christmas visit, is just the party.
Possibly.
I could see that happening. It is kind of fun to see the snow on the Matterhorn, too, coming down.
Yeah, that's a very happy thing.
That is very cool. What was your favorite part of Christmas Fantasy Parade, Katie?
I always love
trumpets.
The stepsisters.
Oh, they were good, too, I guess. Yeah. They're okay. No, they were really good. Beauty and the Beast are back there. 8, 9, 10, and 11. I almost feel like that's a really long line, so we'll just keep walking. Got to see the Muppets. What did you think of that, Katie?
Oh, that was so fun. And it was like the best thing to me was how many people were so excited.
Yeah. And getting the jokes.
All the crowds like
yes.
around the Muppets and the laughter and
it just
worked. It worked and
apparently this is where Beauty and the Beast will be.
I'm about to say something, you'll either get it or you won't. It felt authentically Muppets.
Yeah.
Some things don't feel authentically Muppet sometimes.
It was very enjoyable.
But, yeah, I loved it. It felt right and fun.
See, when you see lines like this for Peter Pan, it makes me think this is, like, their Christmas trip. I don't know. I could be wrong. It is fairly busy, but not insanely busy. And here we come on a brass band.
Thank you.
rides or anything like that? Is there anything fun going on out there? You guys got the lights? We don't have any lights. So there's that. One day. You get that every time you come in? Or hey guys, we're just kind of playing some background music here for you. This is our first time playing together in real life in public in like a year or 2 years or however long. Yeah, thanks for supporting live music.
Thank you.
Over there. And then you may go through.
Like there, the queue is in the room. I don't hear. Yeah, there's a problem.
Sorry.
Oh no, you're fine.
Are they
There also are all these photo ops throughout the park. This one is Coco themed. We saw one that was Frozen themed over in Fantasyland a minute ago by Donald. And they're very cute ideas. We will have to take some photos before the night is up. And then as we're wandering back into Frontierland, there's a mariachi band. And this is very fun.
It's a beautiful song called Mamacita, Donde Está Santa Claus? You guys know it? All right, let's practice it. Mamacita. Oh, that's some awesome singers. One, two, three. Mamacita.
Mamacita.
Deo.
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 Ah, here we go. A ver ese acorde. All right, you guys ready? Mamacita. That's a romantic one. Here we go. One, two, three. Mamacita. ¿Dónde está Santa Claus? ¿Dónde está Santa Claus? And the toys that he will leave. Mamacita.
I'll go with you guys home.
No.
Okay, here we go.
I'm all that.
You went to it.
Tomorrowland, where there are more photo ops to be had, along with some exciting, somewhat loud music, but people are enjoying it, and that's good. I don't know that it's Christmas music, but I could be wrong. But it is fun to see the Toy Story themed photo op right there. And then as we move up here, we will see actually some really cool Christmas tree decorations. And I believe there's also Buzz Lightyear up there, having a blast.
Please.
I just took some more pictures of the Muppets. Angela is seeing the jazz band on the Mark Twain, so we'll probably have photo video of that, actually. And I'm going to go down and see Mickey and Minnie Mouse and their new outfits that were announced earlier today, and hopefully show them to you as well. I will say Muppets are definitely a highlight of the night for a lot of people, and I expect that to just grow as this whole thing goes on. And I really hope we see more stuff like this in the future, because it is a very good use of the Muppets. And it's nice to see them around.
Tony, Jamila Disa, Jeff Littleton, Moyes Lucas, Ricky Z, I'm Mel Collins. Are y'all ready to go? Yeah. Do we have any Louis Armstrong fans up there? Well, then you're in luck. This first song is going to remind you of him.
One, two, three.
for just a second. Because I want to hear the mariachi band. Remind me of this song. Here we go. I'm that doesn't get you in the holiday spirit, I don't know what will. Folks, I have to tell you, we are very, very lucky tonight to have my friend sit in with me, Mr. Jamel Adisa, on trumpet. I'm going to let him take over. Shine one last time. But take it easy on yourself because you've been blowing all night. Jamel and Lisa, everybody. Hey, boys, Lucas, Kevin, Tony. All right, y'all. Well, we better do something pretty and soft so we don't interrupt the chief too much. joined us before we say goodnight to y'all. You listen to Kevin Tony on keys. Jeff Lizen on bass. Miles Lucas on drums. Ricky Z on the banjo. And this is Jamel Adisa on trumpet and vocals. I'm Mel Collins. We're Standard Mel and the Red Hots. I packed up all my cares, but you can't lose.
Attention, attention to our guests we hold dear. We must say good night and see you next year. More time with you we wish we could spend, but it seems our party has come to an end. So we say this now as we turn out the lights. Merry Christmas to all from Merriest Nights.
Party is over. PhotoPass is very graciously staying and letting the lines finish. I think they have closed them, but there is one more photo location. We might not have hit them all, but there is one more. I'm not sure we actually got the one in Adventureland, even though we walked by it. But I think there were six of these if I counted correctly. Perfect right now, and everybody is just streaming out. And it seems somewhat appropriate that Scrooge and Jacob Marley, Goof Marley, Gooferly, I don't know who it is, but it seems appropriate they're the last two out for the night, saying goodnight to guests as they make their way out of the parks. We have survived Disney Merriest Nights. Ooh. The first night. It was a whirlwind of a...
Disney Merriest Nights survive us.
Four hours of magic merriment and Muppets.
Oh.
And you just can't go wrong with that.
M's.
Yeah, you're welcome. Brought to you by the letter M today.
Uh-oh.
But anyway, what'd you think of Merriest Nights, Katie?
I thought it was great. It was... For the average person, it might not be hard to see everything, but if you're obsessed with the Muppets, it might be hard to see everything.
Or all the characters, it's hard to see all of them, too.
Yeah.
Just because some of them rotating in and out, and I think that made it challenging.
But I had a great time. I didn't even eat any of the specialty foods or shop any specialty merchandise or anything
like that. We didn't have time for that.
We didn't, because we were running around
That's
doing
totally
a lot
fine.
Of things. I think that it totally depends on what's important to you.
Yeah, you have to really decide what's important and then go for those things and prioritize.
Yeah.
And that's always, I mean, that's how these things go with just about everything. It looks like they're passing something out as we exit the parks. I would say, don't go to the first night.
Yeah.
Like, unless you're trying to get coverage up and you really, really want to be one of the first people, great. But I would just say, don't go to the first night.
That's kind of a rule for all things Disney.
Yeah. They were figuring things out, which is fine. Mm-hmm. And, thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thank you so much.
And they just gave us a card, it looks like.
It's a postcard.
It's a postcard. Amazing.
Oh, it's a...
That is fun. Thank you, guys.
Thank you.
So we did get a set of postcards. It looks like Frozen is on the front of them. But officially, festival holidays at Disneyland begin right now, actually, because it's after midnight. So technically, it's the 12th now, and they have begun. But yeah, don't go on the first night if you really want to get the most out of it, because then you don't have the insanity of like trying to figure out how everything works. Like, learn from everybody else's mistakes. That's what I was trying to get at. Learn from people like us and be like, oh, I like that, don't like that. And then you can pick what you really want to do instead of guessing, which is what you do first night.
That's just a good rule for being a Disney fan is...
Learn from other people's mistakes.
Learn from other people's mistakes, but also, if you can, usually try to avoid the first day, first night, or like the first of the first. So like first day
Because that's going to be crazy.
First of day of the holidays. If you're here first thing in the morning, you might run into some troubles. So sometimes if you just let things kind of...
Or you just might not know what to do.
Run its course.
Like, I think there's something to be said for letting other people figure out what works and what doesn't work and what they like and what they don't like and learn from that. But we liked this. It was fun. Totally would go again if we could. And we hope you've enjoyed this vlog. We hope you enjoyed our coverage. And we will have stuff up in the coming days, weeks, and months from tonight and beyond with the holidays at Disneyland starting in just a few short hours. We will be back. But please subscribe if you haven't to this YouTube channel, because we would appreciate that. And subscribe on DAPSMAGIC.com for our newsletter. But with that, we are going to go and hopefully get this stuff uploaded as quickly as we possibly can.
Sleep.
Yes. Merry Christmas, everybody.
Merry Christmas.